Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for me to be invited by Director General of IFPRI to address a few comments on European agricultural trade policy and agricultural trade with developing countries. I would like to focus on in my presentation in the following elements. I would like to start with a few facts on EU agricultural trade with developing countries. Of course, Doha development agenda is a very timely subject when we discuss agricultural issue and agricultural policy. I'd like to spend a few minutes on Economic Partnership Agreement, EPA. Also, initiative on everything but arms is very important in the context of agricultural trade of the European Union in developing countries. Last but not least, common agriculture policy reform and health check is one of the subjects I'd like to also raise the brief. I'm going rather quickly through the number of slides I have prepared for today's presentation. Few facts about the trade. First of all, it's important to note that the European Union is net importer of agricultural products. And with growing export positive balance of such countries like Brazil, Argentina, New Zealand, and even Australia, but maybe not in the last period because of drought problem. If we take into account EU agricultural trade with developing countries, it's obvious that during the last 20 years, EU is a net importer of agricultural products from developing countries. EU is net exporter only in relation to processed agriculture products, but raw materials, tropical products, and total balance of trade for the EU with developing countries negative. Developing countries export to the EU substantial part of their export. EU absorbs the main part of the developing countries' agricultural export. With 27 member states, it's very close to 25% of total export of developing countries. It is more than export of developing countries to United States, Canada, Australia, Japan, all together. In case of ACP's agricultural export, of course, EU is also the main absorber of this export. More than 41% of EU of developing country export is directed to the EU market. Switching to agricultural trade policy, I think it's important to start with multilateral trade liberalization negotiations. We are in the very important moment of DDA, Doha Development Agenda negotiations now. And I would stress that EU is in favor to have the development at the center of the round. Special and differential treatment for developing countries in agriculture negotiations are supported by the EU. So such elements of this approach like lower tariff cuts, like longer transitional period, implementation period, like lower cuts in support, this kind of elements of agreement are fully supported by the EU. We are also in favor to support the idea to establish the special product treatment for developing countries. EU is very committed to conclude these negotiations, and we did our homework already. Essential progress was achieved concerning the treatment of sensitive products, and now there is a discussion about tropical products and also preference erosion. Switching to economic partnership agreement, I need to stress that the aim is to achieve the mutually reinforced effect of trade and development aid and foster regional integration. EPA agreement is much more than only trade agreement. The idea of this agreement was concerning trade, including agricultural trade, was to achieve the WTO compatible agreement with six regions with 78 countries. These negotiations were concluded in majority of the countries by end of last year. EU offered unprecedented liberalization to ACP's countries, duty-free, quota-free access to all products from these countries to the European market, except two products, sugar and rice, but for these products we agreed with ACP's countries to have a transitional period, short one for rice and up to 2015 transitional period for sugar. It's important to mention that in this agreement there is asymmetric treatment of ACP's countries, so that opening of the market of ACP's countries is much lower and will be implemented in quite a long period of time. Many products very sensitive for these countries are not included in the agreements, and it's also important to mention that European Union has no offensive interest concerning agricultural export to ACP's countries. Agreement with South Africa is covered by WTO compatible regime under TDCA, and we are discussing further development of trade with this very important food and agricultural producers. EBA, Everything But Arms, this is initiative which gives duty-free, quota-free access for all LDC's countries. The short transitional period has been foreseen for sugar and rice, but from 2009, all sugar, even such sensitive product like sugar for the EU, will be fully will have fully free access to the EU market from October 2009. CAP reform. If we talk about CAP reform, I think we need to mention the series of reform, 2003, decoupling, next reform related to fruits and vegetable sector, sugar, but now we are in the period of the discussion of evaluation of the Common Agriculture Policy Reform, so-called health check. The detailed information will be distributed on that subject presented globally next week. But at this stage, I would like to make a few comments related to this policy. It's important to stress that the current Common Agriculture Policy is a radically reformed policy. Support is mainly decoupled and subject to so-called cross-compliance. It means special requirements which are imposed on farmers to fulfill obligation related to environment protection and animal welfare. In the new Common Agriculture Policy, role of intervention mechanism has been significantly reduced. The general direction of the reform is to provide more support for second pillar, it means rural development, and less support for market measure, for intervention, and of course there are some support in the form of direct payments which are decoupled. In the context of health check, which is now under final stage of discussion on the level of Commission, such issue like climate change and links to the bioenergy demand, water scarcity and risk management are addressed. The ongoing reforms, already completed, and ongoing reforms of common agriculture policy contributed to the reduction in price support. We see that for soft wheat, durum wheat, beef, rice, thanks of the reform, internal EU prices went down by around 50%. And for ongoing reforms, butter, skim milk powder, and sugar, internal EU prices will be reduced substantially in coming months and years. There is a lot of myths and stereotype about the huge financial support for the European Union funds. After enlargement, last enlargement, it means for EU27, we have 14.5 million farmers in the EU. The support is changing. First of all, I would like to stress that the role of export refunds is declining from the level of close to 10 billion euro mid-90s to the level which is close to 2-3 billion euro now, and with the tendency to decline very quickly. The market support is also declining very quickly. There is an increasing role of support in form of direct payment and also rural development programs. I can say that there is no doubt that there is an impact of the common agriculture policy on trade, especially the reduction of trade distortion, distorting measure is evident during last years. The coupling is contributing positively to the elimination and reduction of these trade distorting measures. To fit with the time of presentation, I'd like to conclude my presentation very briefly. The EU is the main trading partner of the developing countries and has a development-friendly trade policy. I think that the graphs I showed quite quickly prove this kind of conclusion. And second important conclusion, CAP reform, including decoupling payments, and the EU positioning in DDA is development friendly. Thank you for your attention.